Welcome to the look at how things are shaking out on the March to Macon. Hashtag March to Macon here at GPB. We're going to let you see how things are in single A, starting off with the Class A private girls. These games will be played in Kennesaw along with the Class A private boys as we go from 8 to 4 and we work our way to the Macon Coliseum in the first weekend of March. Looks like right now a lot of the top seeds are working their way through. St. Francis, we'll talk about them also in a second when we get to the boys. With their win over FPD, Mount Perrin, the 8 goes through. Chalk here as well, the 4 goes, the 5 goes, so you have all your top 4 seeds in the top bracket going through, working your way. So St. Francis takes on Mount Perrin. Southwest Atlanta Christian takes on Lakeview. That's the upper half of the bracket. The lower half, Green Forest Christian, we'll talk about them on the boys' side as well. They knock off Paideia. They make their way through. They're taking on Tatnall Square, who beat Athens Christian. The only upset really on the girls' side was a 7-10, and we all know how those matchups can be a little pesky sometimes. Eagles Landing Christian, the 10 goes through. Calvary Day, we've talked about them out of Savannah, always making their way deep into playoff runs and appearances in Macon as well. That's your Class A private girls, a lot of the favorites making their way through. Boys side, you're going to see a lot of familiar names here. Green Forest Christian as the one. Ike Obiagu and all of the big players that Green Forest Christian has. They won a couple of years ago in the Class A private. They're looking to do it again. They'll take on Tatnall Square, the winner of that one. Takes on the winner of North Cobb Christian and Stratford. The 5 goes through and the 4 goes through. That's your upper bracket. Lower bracket, once again, these are games in Kennesaw. Lakeview, the 3 seed, makes their way through. Whitfield Academy, the 6, so you have a 3 and a 6 working their way through. Pacelli, the 10, once again, it's that pesky 7-10 matchup. The 10 makes their way through, knocking off Our Lady of Mercy. And 2 with Kobe Simmons, St. Francis, the player of the year here in the state of Georgia. He's already heading to Arizona. He's declared he's going to Arizona. So once again, a lot of the favorites making their way through on the private side. These games, the public side, they're down in Valdosta. And it's once again, a lot of the top seeds working their way through. Turner, the 1, Telfair, the 8, Trutland, the 5, Wheeler, the 4. A lot of chalk here. Taylor, the 3 seed, Greenville, the 6, Calhoun and Terrell County, your 2 and your 7. So the top 8 seeds make their way through. Your matchups, Turner and Telfair, Trutland, Wheeler, Taylor, Greenville, Calhoun and Terrell. Once again, these matchups in Valdosta as they make their way through to the March to Macon. On the boys' side, once again, a lot of favorites making their way through here again as well. Trutland, your top seed, put up 90 points, north end of 90 in their first round matchup against Stewart County. They get Hawkinsville, who knocked off Central Talbotton. Wilkinson County, do not underestimate what Wilkinson County does in the postseason. Dr. Aaron Jeter, a lot of titles in single A. They make their way through. The biggest upset in the single A on the boys' side was the 4-13. Lincoln County knocking off perennial power Randolph Clay. Wilkinson County, Lincoln County, that's an interesting matchup there in the north end of that bracket. Lower part of the bracket, Turner County, your 3, Calhoun, your 6, Hancock Central, who's won titles before with Cam Halsey in that group, and also Taylor County, your 2, making your way through, so a lot of the favorites with one big upset. On the boys' side, once again, this will be held in Macon. Be a part of the conversation at GPB Sports, won't you? The brackets are up at gpb.org/sports. Friend us, like us, be a part of the conversation on Facebook and Twitter at GPB Sports.